name's Dave Mittlefehldt. Everyone knows me as Duck, so you can feel free to refer to me by that name. I'm a planetary scientist working with NASA, Johnson Space Center. I've been doing planetary research basically almost all my career, since the mid-70s on, and I'm about to get ready to go to Antarctica, so I've got to make sure I've got all the items I need. We're down there to collect meteorites that have been falling on Antarctica all over the place. These rocks are basically a poor man's space probe. For a fairly low expense, we can sample a multitude of bodies in the solar system, and by studying them in the lab, we can then learn quite a bit about the formation of the solar system, and for the moon and Mars, how those bodies evolved over geologic time. Christchurch is just in late spring, going on to summer, so I've got to make sure I've got shorts, t-shirts, and sandals available, because I don't want to be wearing sweatshirts, flannel shirts, and that sort of thing in 90 degrees in New Zealand. When you're in Christchurch, New Zealand, you get almost all of the ECW, or extreme cold weather gear, you need from the Antarctic terminal in Christchurch, New Zealand, so I don't need to worry about heavy boots for out in the field. I don't need to worry about fleece layers. I don't need to worry about parkas. But what I do need to take is some personal gear, woolen socks. These will keep my feet warm in my boots. They look kind of small, but they work. I only have one pair with me, and the reason is because I shipped my own personal ECW gear out from Houston, so it's already in McMurdo waiting for me. I do have to have one set because they will not let you on the plane from Christchurch to McMurdo Station if you don't have the proper ECW gear with you. One pair of expedition weight thermal underwear, and I've got, I think I took shipped four other pair down there, so I'm all set. McMurdo Station is, it's gonna be cold down there. It is the summer. Temperatures will be below freezing almost the entire time. But it's not like you're out in the middle of nowhere. You're kind of in a, any town in Minnesota in the winter. So you wanna have stuff to keep warm outside. So I might include a fleece pullover. That's always good to have. You need flannel shirts. The other thing is, you need a good pair of hiking boots. These are mine. The dust there is from Death Valley. I was there last March. Now, sleeping in the tent in Antarctica, you're sleeping in a sleeping bag. The only time I really change down there is at night. I shed my daytime clothes and wear what I'm going to sleep in. What I like is a sweatshirt and basically some kind of running pants type things that are warm. The sun's up 24/7. So what I do is I take a heavy knit hat. You need to keep your head warm when you're sleeping, and then I just pull it over my eyes and it's dark and I can go to sleep, no problems. I can't do without coffee, but I'm not gonna drink instant coffee. So this is a coffee cone. I will ship this. Actually, I'll take this with me. And cone filters. I've also already shipped cans of coffee already ground that I like, so I can enjoy all the comforts of home minus the heat while I'm in Antarctica. One of the things you probably never thought about for Antarctica is sunburn. Like I said, the sun's up 24/7. The scene around you is extremely bright. It's all ice, light blue ice or white snow. Sunlight reflects off of all of that. And even though the sun is at a low angle to the horizon, you can get a wicked sunburn on anything that's exposed. The other thing you need, these are my glacier glasses. I bought these, the frames, and had my prescription put in them. They come with side shields. They're very dark. So when I put them on, basically the light is blocked all the way around. That way I won't get snow blindness. One of the times I was down there, this was would have been in 2001 trip, we spent 4 days solid stuck in our tents with basically hurricane force winds blowing. We didn't go out unless we had to, and we just certainly didn't go out and work. So you need something to read. The advantage of this is that this right here, which weighs almost nothing, is equivalent to, you know, a whole suitcase full of books. Sometimes power is at a short supply. We take solar panels so that I can recharge my Kindle. But sometimes you need paper copies, so I like taking cryptogram books. They occupy my mind. I lived in Israel for 6 years. I'm taking a novel in Hebrew and an English-Hebrew dictionary. This time, if we have tent days, I'm going to try and refresh my memory on how to read Hebrew. Everything is frozen, no surprise there. The good news is you don't have to refrigerate anything. You just leave it in a box outside your tent, and it'll stay nicely frozen the whole time. You never have to worry about it. There's tons of water all around you. If you want to make a cup of coffee, the first thing you do is you go outside your tent, chip a block of ice, put it in a pot, turn on the gas stove, and wait until the ice melts and then boils, and then you can make yourself a cup of coffee. But there's no shortage of water out there, that's for sure. Come about 4 or 5 months from now, we'll hopefully bring back maybe 1,000 new meteorites here, store them over there in Building 31 North, and then have them go through processing and distribution to scientists for study. This is going to be an exciting time. I'm looking forward to it.
Subscribe for more space.